Hello students, welcome back to the online class. Today we are going to discuss a new topic in HTML5, that is CSS. CSS, that is cascading style sheets. Cascading style sheets. So cascading style sheet is used to format the layout of a web page. It is used to what? It is used to format the layout of a web page. Okay, it is used to format the layout of a web page. For example, you are working with a project, say like you are developing a website. So for creating a website, you need web pages. Means website means what? It is a collection of web pages. So every web pages you need to format. You need to format every web pages, font, colors, sizes, his positions, everything. So in that case, you have to use HTML. You have to use HTML5 and plus also CSS. So CSS is a what? It is a cascading style. It is a what? It is a language which is used to format the layout of a web page. The layout can be changed with the help of CSS. Yes, we can also change with the help of HTML, but HTML can change not the high level, but CSS is a high level. It means CSS is used to change the web page in a very high level, very good position. It means when you're using CSS, the web page looks very attractive. Okay, nowadays in every web pages, in every websites, use CSS, because without CSS, the websites looks odd. Means very poor websites, like only just text and images are coming, nothing else. So now today's world, the viewers want attractive websites, just like Amazon, Flipkart, Instagram, Facebook. These are what? These are attractive websites. Means what? In that website you can see a lot of updates coming, features, new features. So many modes it's in this website. So these websites are called attractive website, and this is called dynamic websites. So these websites are used with the help of CSS. Okay, so CSS is used to format the layout of the web page. Okay, so it creates the layout and it also changes the layout of a web page. So that's why nowadays we use CSS. So CSS basically used to for controlling the colors, for controlling the colors of the web page, font of the web page, the size of the text, and say like space between the elements, how elements are positioned, means how elements are aligned, left, right, middle. These are the things. And also the background images, the background colors, these are so important in every web pages. And also the displays between different devices and different screen size, means the color of the device, the color of the web page in different web devices. So it means it creates dynamic. Okay, and much more. So that's why CSS is so important in today's developing a web site, okay, or web page. Now today we discuss these things. What is actually CSS? In your book you can see page number 262. CSS is a language that provides a set of rules for displaying elements on web page. Markup languages generally use CSS for describing the look and feel of web pages by defining the layout, colors, and fonts. Web browsers refer CSS for defining the layout and looks for your web content. The W3C, that is World Wide Web Consortium, encourages using CSS in place of HTML presentation elements. Okay, the World Wide Web Consortium. This is what is a consortium who actually wants CSS to present the details of a websites with the help of CSS. So that's why nowadays every website use CSS. Okay, now how it is used? You can see there are the syntax of CSS is are given here. Syntax of CSS rule is rules. First you can see here selector bracket property 1 property value value 1 comma property 2 property 2 property value 2 etc. Okay, so this is the what? This is the CSS rules. Okay, now where it is mean selector? Selector means what? Where selector stands for HTML elements which the rules is defined. Selector elements may be different. Say sometimes selector elements, HTML elements, say like body, say like any paragraph P, select any table, frame, these are the elements. Okay, so you can use these elements change with the help of this CSS rules. Okay, now you can see in the video, you can see property 1, property 2, etc. represents the properties, that is the attributes of the elements. Means the attribute means what? What is the meaning of attributes? Attributes means additional information of a particular element. Okay, so here you can see represents properties or attributes of the elements. Property 1 value, property 2 value, etc. represents the values assigned to the various properties. So properties, values, what is values 2, these are the values of the attributes. Okay, now you can see in the last position, you can see there is an example given here. Body so this is the not bracket, this is curly bracket, it is also curly bracket. Body background color yellow. Okay, background color yellow, background repeat background repeat this repeat why means yes. Repeat Y equal means yes. Okay, now you can see this is the exact CSS coding. This is the CSS coding. This part. Okay, you can see here there is a body element. This is the element of the HTML body. In the body part, you can change the background color of the body. Means the websites, so the web page body color should be yellow. Okay, it should be yellow. And background repeat means what? When you scroll the means your background, means when you go up and down, then the color will be same. Yes, repeat yes, white. So that's why it is called, this is the properties, this is called the properties, this is called the properties, and this is the properties value. Property value. Okay, now with the help of this CSS we can easily change the layout of a web page. Okay, so in this way we can easily change the layout of a web page. Now you can see CSS style can be incorporated in HTML document in all the following ways. So there are three ways we can incorporate it in an HTML document. We can use these three ways we can use a CSS in HTML coding. So these three ways are discussed now. Three ways. First way, three ways. The first way is external style sheet. External style sheet. In external style sheets, what happened? An external style sheet has a separate document that contains only CSS rules and has the extension .css. These are used to apply a uniform style to many web pages without writing the same code again. Means what? This external style is actually an external document, or you can say external file. This file actually what? CSS rules. Includes, this file includes CSS rules. Okay, these are not included in the HTML code. Okay, you have to save this document or file with the help of .css extension. Because this external style sheet is used actually for the purpose of not only one web pages, it can be used in different web pages. Means what? This external style sheet is stored in different different sites. Okay. So means what? In external website, external style sheet is stored in differently, included in the HTML tag. Okay. So you can use this CSS, this external style sheet, in different web pages. You can use this external style sheet in different web pages, because this is not only for getting on, only for getting on one pages. It is used for different web pages. Okay, so means what? You cannot write the same code again and again. Same code. No need to write the same code, because if you already write the code, this is, for example, you want to change the background of the color, background repeat, headings color, headings font. So you can just write the rules in this external style sheets, and you can save this style sheet in different positions or different place, so that you can easily use this style sheet in different web pages. Okay, so no need to write the same code again and again. This is the advantage of this external style sheets. So that's why it is used for basically in different websites. So it is actually apply a uniformly style to many web pages without writing the same code again and again. So that's why it is so important for a web developer to know that what is actually external style sheets. Okay, next one is embedded style sheets. Next one is embedded. Embedded style sheet. So embedded style sheets, actually what happened in this case, a set of style is created as part of an HTML document. These are used when you want to apply similar styles to different elements on the same web page, and the embedded style sheet is created using style tag inside the head tag. Okay, means what? This actually embedded style sheet is used for only one web page. Only one web page you can web page only one web page can use. Means what? In different elements of the same HTML document. Okay, for example, you want to change the background color, you want to change the pixel positions, you want to change the say the pre-dubs alignment. So you can use this embedded style sheet. So for a reason you have to use the style tag. So style tag is used for this purpose. So with the help of style tags, you can use the embedded style sheet in only one web pages. The particular web pages you can use, but style tag is used under the what? Under head tag. So you have to use on not only style sheet, you have to use the head tag. In head tags, in the between the head tags, you can use the style tag, and in the style tags, you can use different CSS codings. Okay. For example, background images, pixels, positions, differently. Okay, so that's why embedded style sheet means what? You can use the CSS coding in the same web pages. Okay, when you want to have similar styles in different elements on the same web pages. Okay, different elements but on the same web pages. This is called embedded style sheets. Okay, now next one is inline style. Number 3 is inline style. Inline styles. Okay. What is the meaning of inline styles? Using inline styles, you can apply a style to specific element of a web page. For these styles, attribute to added HTML tags. Okay. Inline style is basically applied to a style, a specific element of your web page. Means you can use this style tag for a specific element. For example, you want to use this in the body tag. In the body tag, you can use these things, but you have to use the what? Style tag. Style attribute. Sorry, STY. And style attribute. To use inline styles, add the style attribute to the relevant element. You have to use the style attribute to the relevant element. You have to use the style attribute to the relevant element. For example, you want to change the background color. Okay. For example, you want to change the background color. Background means a P. So you have to use the P tag. Okay. After that, you write style color red. So to write the P tag, style equal to color dot red. Okay, so in this way you can easily change the color of the playground. So this is the element, this is the HTML element playground, and this is the style attribute. Okay, so that's why it is used when it is an inline style may be used to apply a unique style for a single element. A single element you can use the inline styles. Okay, now to use the inline styles, add the styles attribute to the relevant element. Okay, the style attribute can contain any CSS properties. Okay, so this is the why you can use the inline styles. Inline styles means you can use a specific element, particular element. Okay, so this is the three way we can use the CSS coding in a web page in our HTML documents. It is so important. In your exams, it may become for this CSS and what are three way we can use this CSS coding. Okay, that's why it is so important. So you can just read this chapter, read this page very carefully. It is very very important paragraph or a very very important topic in HTML file. So if you have any problems after watching this video, then you can ask me in our doubting sessions. So today we discuss what is CSS, cascading style sheets, and the three way, that is XML style sheet, embedded style sheet, and inline style. Okay. So if you have any problem, please ask me in the upcoming session. So the upcoming sessions, I again repeat, please come in the upcoming session. This is so important for you. Okay. Thank you everybody for watching this video. Again I say, stay at home and be safe. Have a great day. Thank you.